This is topic number 20, indeterminate forms. Okay, so for complicated functions for which we cannot find the limits directly, for example, if you are going to get it as 0 by 0 form or 0 into infinity or infinity by infinity form, we will be calling those type of forms as indeterminate forms. So now, for example, if you are going to apply the limit as a, if the numerator is going to become 0 or if the denominator is going to become 0, then we call this as a 0 by 0 form, that is indeterminate form. If we want to find the limit for these type of functions, we will be differentiating the numerator separately and denominator separately. Then after that, we will be applying the limit. Okay. So by doing so, we can get a finite value. Okay. The same process can be repeated till you get a finite value. So this we call it as a L'Hospital's rule. Right. So let us see a problem here. It is evaluate limit extending to 0. X e power x minus log of 1 plus x by x square. So, if you apply the limits, what will happen to this term? This is 0 e to the power 0 minus log of 1 plus 0 divided by 0. So, anything for 0 is 1. So, 1 into 0 will be 0 and this is log 1 divided by 0. So, obviously log 1 is 0. So, you are going to get an indeterminate form 0 by 0 form. So, since this is 0 by 0 form, we are going to differentiate the numerator separately and denominator separately. Afterwards, we are going to apply the limit. When you differentiate the numerator, in the first term, it is a combination of two x terms. So, it is x e power x plus when you differentiate, you will get e power x into 1. And similarly, when you come to the second term of the numerator, it is log of 1 plus x. When you differentiate it, you will get 1 by 1 plus x divided by, for x square, it is 2x. When you apply the limit as 0, this is 0 plus, it is e power 0 minus 1 by 1 plus 0 divided by 0. So, this is 1 minus 1 by 0. Again, you are facing the 0 by 0 form. Okay. So, again, you are going to apply the same concept. That is, you are going to differentiate the numerator again, the new one. So, what will happen? This will be x e power x plus e power x. And for the second term, it is e power x. So, this is plus e power x. For 1 by 1 plus x, when you differentiate this 1 by 1 plus x, it is nothing but 1 plus x the whole power minus 1. When you differentiate, you will get it as minus 1, 1 plus x the whole power minus 2. Or you can write it as minus 1 by 1 plus x the whole square. So, this is nothing but minus 1 by 1 plus x the whole square. Already you have a negative sign. So, minus into minus will become plus divided by, when you differentiate the denominator, this is going to give you the value as 2. Now, you can apply the limit as x tending to 0. So, what will happen when you apply the limit as x tending to 0? This is going to be 0 e power 0 plus e power 0 plus e power 0 plus 1 by 1 plus 0 the whole square divided by 2. So, e power 0 is nothing but 1. Okay, first term is 0. So, this is 1 plus 1 plus 1 by 1 the whole square is again 1 divided by 2. So, this is going to give the value as 3 by 2. Therefore, the value of limit x tending to 0 x e power x minus log of 1 plus x divided by x square is nothing but 3 by 2. Okay. Now, we will move on to the second problem. Evaluate limit extending to 0 tan x log x. So, this is tan x log x. What is tan x? Tan x can be written as 1 divided by cot x. So, this is limit extending to 0. I can write this as log x divided by cot x. When you apply the limit as 0, what will happen? Log 0 divided by cot 0. So, both log 0 and cot 0 are undefined. Both are undefined. It means that infinity by infinity form. This is going to give you infinity by infinity form. Now, we are going to apply the L'Hospital's rule. As L'Hospital's rule is nothing but you are going to differentiate the numerator separately and denominator separately. When you differentiate the numerator, log x will give you 1 by x, cot x will give you minus cosecant square x. Let us find the value of this limit. This is equivalent to limit x tending to 0. We can rewrite this as minus sin square x divided by x. So, when you apply the limit as 0, what is the value of sin 0? Is 0. Therefore, this is also 0 by 0 form. Okay. So, again we are going to differentiate. So, again we are going to differentiate. Again differentiating. What will happen? This will give you limit x tending to 0 minus For sine square theta, it is 2 sine theta. For sine theta, it is cos theta divided by 1. When you apply the limit as 0, this will give you minus 2 sine 0 into cos 0. So, this is going to give you the value as 0. So, this is the answer for this problem, right? Now, we will move on to the next problem. Evaluate limit extending to pi by 2 sine x to the power tan x. So, it is a power function. Whenever you see a power function like that, let us take this as y. So, let y is equivalent to limit extending to pi by 2 sine x to the power tan x. So, by taking log on both sides, we get log y is equal to limit extending to pi by 2 tan x, using the log property, log a power n is equal to n log a. So, tan x will come to the front. So, this is log sin x. So, you can rewrite this as we did in the previous problem. This is equivalent to log of sin x divided by cot x. Now, let us apply the limit as pi by 2. So, this is going to give you log sin pi by 2 divided by cot pi by 2. So, cot pi by 2 is nothing but 1 by tan pi by 2. So, that is going to give you the value as 0. And same way, sin 90, it is going to give you the value as 1. Log 1 is going to be 0. So, you are going to get the value as 0 by 0 form. So, again, you are going to differentiate. Differentiating the numerator and denominator. Both numerator and denominator, we are going to differentiate. So, when you differentiate, what will happen? This will be limit extending to pi by 2. For log sin x, it is 1 by sin x. Differentiation of sin x is cos x. Divided by differentiation of cot x is minus cosecant square x. So, you can rewrite this as limit extending to pi by 2 to pi by 2. And in the numerator, you have 1 by sin x. Okay. So, let me write the same step again. 1 by sin x into cos x divided by minus cosecant square x. You can rewrite this as limit extending to y by 2 minus sin square x divided by sin x into cos x. So, sin term will get cancelled, one term will get cancelled. So, the remaining will be limit extending to pi by 2 minus sin x into cos x. Now, let us apply the limit as pi by 2. So, this will be sin pi by 2 into cos pi by 2. So, what is the value of cos pi by 2? It is going to be 0. Therefore, this will give you the value as 0. So, this is the answer for this problem. Okay. So, this is how we are supposed to solve an indeterminate form. Okay. So, thank you. We will stop with this. Thank you.